Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in this video, we will see that how to represent the spatial numbers like the 0 and infinity as well as the denormalized number in the floating point representation. So in the previous video, we have seen that how to represent any floating point number in the single precision and the double precision format. So we have seen that in this format, first the floating point number is normalized. And once it is normalized, then it will have the three fields. That is sine, exponent and the mantissa. So in this IEEE format, the exponent value is stored in the biased form, meaning that in the exponent value, the specific value of bias is added. And then after, this exponent value is stored in this exponent field. So because of this bias value, all the negative values of the exponent will get shifted towards the positive side. And in this IEEE single precision format, this exponent value is stored in the 8 bits. So as you know, in the 8 bits, we can represent any number from 0 to 255. And we have seen that out of this total range, the values of all zeros and all ones is reserved for the spatial numbers. So in this video, let us see how to represent the spatial numbers in this IEEE format. So in this IEEE format, for any normalized number, the range of the exponent is from -126 to +127. So the minimum value of the exponent is equal to -126. And if you see the corresponding value of the exponent, then that is equal to 1. Now with the smallest value of the exponent, if the mantissa field is also 0, then that represents the smallest value of the normalized number. That is equal to 1.0 times this 2 to the power -126. And depending on the sign, we will have the positive or the negative number. So on the number line, these are the smallest normalized numbers. That means if we talk about the single precision format, then in the normalized form, we cannot represent any number smaller than this value. So for example, if we want to represent this 0 in this normalized form, then also we cannot represent it. Because if you see any normalized number, then it is represented in this format. That means the significant digit before the binary point is always equal to 1. Therefore, it is not possible to represent the 0 in this normalized form. So for representing such spatial numbers like 0 and infinity, this exponent value of all zeros as well as the all ones is used. So whenever this exponent field is 0 and the mantissa field is also 0, then that represents the number 0. Similarly, when the exponent field is 0 and the mantissa field is non-zero, then that represents the denormalized numbers. So in this IEEE 754 standard, these denormalized numbers are the special type of floating point numbers which are used to represent the very small values, which is very close to 0. And in fact, if you see the values of this denormalized number, then they are even smaller than the smallest normalized number in this 32-bit format. That means these numbers covers the range between the 0 and this smallest normalized numbers. Now, if you see the representation of these denormalized numbers, then it is different than the normalized numbers. So in the normalized binary numbers, we have seen that the significant digit before the binary point always remains 1. But in this case, if you see, then the digit before the binary point always remains 0. So here, after the binary point, we have the 23 bits of the mantissa field, and then after we have this exponential term. So here, since the exponent is always 0, so this exponential term will always remain 2 to the power -126. That means this is the typical way of representing the denormalized numbers. That means in this denormalized numbers, the exponent field will always remain 0, while the mantissa field will be non-zero. That means if we have been given any 32-bit number in the single precision format, then just by looking at these two fields, we can say that whether the given number is in normalized form or the denormalized form. So to understand that, let us take one example. So let's say this is the 32-bit number in the single precision format, which is given in the hexadecimal form. So first of all, let us represent this number in the binary form. So as you know, this 8 in the binary corresponds to 1000, and likewise the C in the binary corresponds to 1100. So this is the corresponding 32-bit number in the binary form. So now we know that in the 32-bit single precision format, the first bit represents the sign bit, and in this case that is equal to 1. Then after, the next 8 bit corresponds to the exponent, and then after, the next 23 bit corresponds to the mantissa. So as you can see over here, the exponent field is equal to 0, while the mantissa field is equal to non-zero. So it indicates that the given number is the denormalized number. So now let us find the value of this number. So we know that any denormalized number can be represented in this format, where this b represents the mantissa part. So here, since the sign bit is equal to 1, that means the given number is the negative number. And here, since the exponent field is 0, so this exponential term will be equal to 2 to the power minus 126. And as you can see over here, this mantissa field is equal to 0011. That means this is the value of the denormalized number. So in this way, just by looking at the exponent field and the mantissa field, we can easily find whether the given number is normalized or the denormalized. So in this mantissa field, when all the bits are 1, then that represents the largest value of the denormalized number. And if we see the same number on the number line, then it will be very close to the smallest normalized number. So keeping all the fields same, when the sign bit is equal to 1, then that represents the smallest negative denormalized number. And on the number line, if you see the same number, then it will be very close to the smallest negative normalized number. So as you can see, in this range, there is a smooth transition from the normalized number to the denormalized number. So similarly, now let us see all the spatial numbers when the exponent field is all 1s. So whenever in this exponent field we have all 1s and in the mantissa part we have all 0s, then that represents the infinite number. And corresponding to the sign bit, we have the plus infinite and the minus infinite. So similarly, when the exponent field is all 1s and the mantissa field is non-zero, then that represents the NaN, where the NaN stands for the not a number. So this NaN, or a not a number, is a special value used in the floating point arithmetic to represent the results that is undefined or the unrepresentable. For examples, the arithmetic operations like 0 by 0 or infinite by infinite will result in the undefined result. Likewise, the multiplication of the infinite to 0 or the addition or subtraction of the plus infinite and the minus infinite will also result in this undefined result. And likewise, if we take the square root of the negative number, then that will also result in the undefined result. So all such arithmetic operations will lead us to this NaN result. So these are some spatial numbers which is represented using the exponent values of all 1s and the all 0s. So if I just summarize, then when exponent value is all 1s and the mantissa field is 0, then that corresponds to plus minus infinity. And whenever this mantissa field is non-zero, then that corresponds to the NaN. Similarly, when the exponent field is 0 and the mantissa field is also 0, then that represents the 0. And likewise, when the exponent field is all 0s and the mantissa field is non-zero, then that represents the denormalized numbers. And for the normalized numbers, this exponent value is other than all 0s and the all 1s. So far in our discussion, we only talked about the single precision numbers. But the same thing is also applicable to the double precision numbers. So I hope in this video you understood how the spatial numbers like 0 and infinite and the denormalized numbers are represented in this IEEE format. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.